We just got done watching a fantastic basketball game between the Golden State Warriors and the Dallas Mavericks. A game that came right down to the wire. The Golden State won in Dallas 127 to 125. This was a really high scoring game. Both teams were missing their second best player in Andrew Wiggins and Kyrie Irving. The Golden State Warriors have struggled on the road all year, and this was really important for seeding. With a win, the Dallas Mavericks would have had the lead in the season series against the Warriors and would have jumped them in the standings. With a loss, the Dallas Mavericks fall to the 9 seed. The Golden State Warriors are now a half game behind the Los Angeles Clippers for the 5 seed. So this was very, very important for both basketball squads, especially because that Paul George injury and both of their chances to get to compete in the Western Conference in the playoffs coming up. The Golden State Warriors played an awesome basketball game, and all year, there's been so much controversy surrounding this team, from even before the season with the Draymond Jordan Poole mess, and going into the season when they struggled on the road, when they were 20 and 20 after 40 games, 30 and 30 after 60 games, a team that, you know, kind of really was stuck in that mediocre middle of the pack range. And then Andrew Wiggins has been out for, I think they said tonight was his 17th or 18th straight game, and they're not sure when he's coming back. So this was a game that was really, really important to the Warriors, I think, to their morale, to their playoff chance, to their, you know, title chances, and so much more. So we're going to break down this game tonight and talk about what I saw from both teams, what I really liked, some of the things I didn't like from Dallas as well. Before we get into it, take a second to subscribe to the channel. We're up over 1,100 subscribers. We're grinding like crazy. We're growing like crazy. And as we get into the playoffs, we'll be doing videos every night, and it'll be a ton of fun. So don't forget to subscribe. So tonight, the Golden State Warriors had a really good mix of who scored. Steph Curry only had 20 points, but he had 13 assists, which is incredible. Draymond Green had one of his better games of the season, and honestly, it encapsulates everything that makes Draymond Green so valuable. He had 14 points, 8 assists, 3 steals, and 4 blocks. That's incredible. He was unbelievable on the defensive end of the court, and that's what Draymond does. Kevon Looney had 12 points, 12 rebounds, massively important game. Dante DiVincenzo had 14 points. Jonathon Kuminga had 22 points on 9 of 11 shooting, which is fantastic. Jordan Poole had 16 points. Lamb and Jamichael Green both had 9 points as well. So they got so much contributions from so many guys. And that's one of the things that I think has really been lacking with the Warriors this year. They hoped that they were going to see some of their young guys take that step forward. Moses Moody, Wiseman, Jonathon Kuminga, even Jordan Poole. And for much of the season, those guys kind of struggled to catch their footing, find their role on a team that's competing for a championship while also trying to develop and give their guys time. And I think the thing that frustrates me so much about when I listen to the media, when I listen to a lot of the sports shows that I like listening to, is that after games, the media just tends to overreact so aggressively that it's like, yeah, the Warriors have struggled a little bit. Right now, they're the 6th seed, almost the 5 seed. And the conversation is, are the Warriors going to miss the playoffs, or are the Warriors championship contenders? And there's never any there's never any middle ground that's like, hey, this team can be one of the contenders because of their championship pedigree, because they have Steph Curry, one of the top 10 basketball players of all time. Klay Thompson, Draymond Green, two of the best role players of all time, and, you know, maybe even better than role players. I don't want to discount their contribution, but and one of the best coaches of all time in Steve Kerr. So there's so many people that you're hearing the Warriors have no chance to make the playoffs or to win a championship, to come out of the West. That is a wild thing to say when we saw what they did last year. They're right in the running this year. And with all the injuries, with all the question marks, with all the other teams in the Western Conference, this Golden State Warriors team is right in the mix in that Western Conference. And I think, obviously, what's very, very important is the Andrew Wiggins piece to all this. We saw last year in the playoffs what he did to the Boston Celtics, what he did on that run to the playoffs, how he was able to defend Luka in the Western Conference Finals, how he was able to... you know, score 20 points a game and also be one of their best defenders on the court. So obviously him coming back and him being back at 100% will be very, very important. I do think if he's not able to come back and whatever he's dealing with, let's not speculate on it, because I have seen some stuff going around social media, and really it's frustrating to hear that. And all the made up rumors is really not great. I don't think for the sport, it's not great if this guy's actually going through something. And clearly if you're out, from your job for a month, month and a half, you're going through something serious. So, you know, spreading rumors, things that he's got to deal with, he's already dealing with enough. He doesn't need to have to deal with this. So shut those down. But if Andrew Wiggins can't come back, I do think that's a concern for the Golden State Warriors. Their road record, obviously, it's been really weird how much they've struggled on the road, but they've won two games in a row, beat Dallas tonight. And the thing about the Western Conference is that even though the Warriors have struggled defensively on the road, in specific guarding the three-point line, the Western Conference isn't full of a bunch of defensive juggernauts. So if you're able to get to the playoffs and you get a first-round series, you absolutely feel like you have a chance against anybody. So the people that have written the Golden State Warriors off, to me, are just foolish. Those same people will tell you that the Lakers are favorites in the Western Conference, even though the Lakers right now currently sit at the 11 or 12 seed. And I don't want to go off on a Lakers tangent. It just drives me nuts how the media handles basketball discussion. They don't talk about what's happening on the court. We don't talk about what we've seen in the past. What we want to do is provide hot takes and our Lakers support year after year. So the most encouraging thing to me, and the thing that's so special about the Warriors, and it really can't be overstated, is that even though Steph Curry only had 20 points tonight, the 13 assists were incredible, but the gravity that he brings every time the basketball is in his hand sets up the entire offense. And I don't know that there's been any player ever that demands the attention, the gravity, the just absolutely your whole game plan's got to be, let's not let this guy get an open shot. And it leaves so many guys for wide open looks, especially when you're playing a pretty poor defensive team and Luka Doncic, Christian Wood on the court, a lot of guys in Dallas that are not top tier defenders. So when those guys are already not great, and then you have Steph Curry, who's so good off ball, so good on ball, and you have guys helping out, you're ending up with wide open shots everywhere. And the Warriors didn't shoot very good tonight, even with it. 30% from the three line. They lost the turnover battle, but they dominated on the boards. 44 rebounds to 31. They absolutely dominated on the boards, and that's really, really important. I think when you look at these teams and you're talking about in the Western Conference, defense is going to be something that's very important. Every year, the old mantra, defense wins championships, I don't think that necessarily applies anymore. But timely defense, I think, wins championships. Being able to get big stops and big moments is going to be really, really important, because a lot of these games in the playoffs in the Western Conference, I think, are going to be close. They're going to be tight. And it's going to come down to what star can make more plays a lot of the time. And when Steph Curry goes and makes a play and is able to kick to a wide open Klay Thompson or Dante DiVincenzo or whoever else is on the court at that time, I think that being able to get stops is going to be more important than anything. And when you have Draymond Green, who had some unbelievable blocks and steals tonight, he had one block, the ball was passed out to the corner, and I don't remember who was shooting it, but it looked like he had one of those Space Jam arms. It's just like he extended so far, he blocked it. It was unbelievable. And that's what Draymond Green's able to do. And if you are able to get Andrew Wiggins back for that playoff run, you're going to have two guys that can go out there and really make stops. Kevon Looney moves his feet pretty well for a big guy, does pretty good switching on to Luka Doncic. And then Steph is no slouch defensively. He's not, you know, never going to be in the Defensive Player of the Year conversation, but he plays really hard. He's smart. He's good with his hands. And then Klay Thompson was always a very good defender. And even though he's kind of lost a step, he still can be a good defender at times. So this Warriors team, when you're talking about the playoffs and when you're talking about big moments, I would have massive faith that the Warriors can get a stop, more so than I would almost any other team in the Western Conference, beside maybe the Grizzlies, but I don't think the Grizzlies' offense is as good as the Warriors. So, all around, this Golden State Warriors team is still a threat in the Western Conference. We cannot write them off. We cannot have any hot takes that this season is over, that the Steph Curry era is over. None of that. Let's wait and see how it plays out. Let's see how the Warriors do in the playoffs, and I'm super excited to see how they perform. I want to talk a second about the Dallas Mavericks. When they traded for Kyrie Irving, I made a video, and I talked about that trade and said I was pretty skeptical of the matching of Kyrie Irving and Luka Doncic. Now, obviously, they haven't played a ton of games on the court together, and even when they have, it's not been very good. But I was called a clown for saying that I wasn't sure that that was going to work. Not even saying that I was 100% positive it wouldn't work, but I wasn't sure that that pairing would work. This team now drops to the 9 seed in the Western Conference. If the Utah Jazz pull it out against Portland tonight, which right now it doesn't look like they will, but if they were to, this team would drop to the 10 seed. The Lakers are also playing right now, could tie them in the standings. This is absolutely looking like a disaster that you got rid of Dorian Finney-Smith, who was probably your best defender, and Spencer Dinwiddie, who was a playmaker. So all around, I'm a little frustrated by what the Dallas Mavericks did. I know you got to make a splash move, make it feel like you're catering to Luka, trying to get him some help. But I don't think bringing in Kyrie Irving was the play at all. If I'm wrong about that, I'm someone who will readily admit that I was wrong. But all in all, I don't like the way that Dallas plays. I don't like the way their defense looks. They shot the lights out. They had some guys that were unbelievable. Bullock was unbelievable. And then Jaden Hardy off the bench had 27 points on 6 of 9 from 3. Guys shot the lights out. Those two guys were unbelievable. Luka had 30 points, 17 assists. And they lost at home to the Golden State Warriors without Andrew Wiggins. And again, you're missing Kyrie Irving. I get it. But all in all, I don't like what Dallas is doing. I don't think I like Jason Kidd as a head coach. I don't know that I think he's great. I think there's a reason he's bounced around from job to job. I don't think that all in all, I'm frustrated by the Dallas Mavericks. I'm frustrated by some of the moves that they've made. And I think when you're talking about building a team around Luka Doncic, it can't be the way that they have. It simply can't be. You have too many poor defenders on the court. And it's just not going to work. It's not going to work. If I'm wrong, fantastic. I will get on here and admit that I'm wrong. I love Luka Doncic. I think he's very fun to watch. I think he's one of the best players in the NBA. But this squad's not going to work. It's not going to be a real contender. All in all, pumped to see how this playoffs goes, especially as it's heating up here in the final 10 games of the season. And massive win from the Golden State Warriors tonight. I was highly impressed. Highly impressed by how they played basketball tonight. The heart that they showed. I really hope Andrew Wiggins comes back. I hope everything's going well with what he's dealing with. That's all we got for you. Don't forget to subscribe. Cyborg guy.